Open Inkscape, go to View, Zoom, Zoom to 1 to 2. Go to File, Document Properties, and make the display units pixels. Select the Rectangle tool, pan the canvas to make the page border go out of the view by middle clicking and moving the mouse. And draw a rectangle, give it a width of 480 by 1000 pixels. Let's turn on the page grid. Go to View, Page Grid. Double click the rectangle and edit the radius by dragging the small circle down. Select the Select tool again. Right click, Duplicate. Give it a color of white. Hold Shift and reduce the width. And again hold Shift and reduce the height. Now double click and adjust the radius of the rectangle. Let's make a new object for the edge. Select both the screen and the background and right click, Duplicate, and go to Path, Difference. Now you can see the edge is remaining. Draw a rectangle again. Give it a black color and resize it to make a pill shape. Select both the pill and the screen by holding Shift and clicking on them. Go to Object, Align and Distribute, or use Ctrl+Shift+A on your keyboard and center it on the vertical axis. I'll give the edge a different color for a while. Now draw a square around the top left corner. Make the edges sharp and change the color. Duplicate the edge by going to right click, Duplicate. Select the square and bring it forward. Now select both and go to Path, Intersection. I changed the color just for the visualization. Make the duplicated edge black again. And select Linear Gradient button on the Fill and Stroke menu. Now select the Gradient tool by tapping G or from the toolbar. And select the first stopper and give it a white color. An alpha value of 40. Right click and duplicate and flip it horizontally by using this button and place it on the other corner of the phone. Make sure you have snapping turned down. Duplicate again and take the gradient to the top. And rotate it to be vertical. Duplicate again and flip it vertically using this button. Now select the top left edge object and bring it front. I'll turn off the page grid for now. Give this a mesh gradient by selecting this button. Now select the Mesh Edit tool and select the three corners by holding Shift and clicking on them and give them a transparent color, that is, make the alpha channel 0. Now adjust the bottom right node then the top left node. Now adjust the other nodes to make it a uniform gradient from the corners. Select the object and duplicate. flip it horizontally and move it to the top right of the phone. Now select both of them and duplicate it and flip it horizontally and bring it down. I'll adjust the four corner nodes again and make it a little less white. Now import an image file onto the canvas to make the home screen. Go to Fill and Stroke menu, adjust the opacity to see-through. Place the image so that the clock can be placed just over the mountain. Now select the white screen underneath the image by holding Alt and clicking 2 times. Bring it forward. Make the image opaque. Go to Object, Clip, Set Clip. Select the text tool and type in the time and make it a little transparent. Go to Text, Text and Font and change the font. I selected Inter as my font. Convert the text to an object by going to Path, Object to Path. Right click, Ungroup. Now place the numbers close to each other by using the arrow key. Convert them into a single object by going to Path Union. Send the image backwards and one step forward again. Now place the clock just over the mountain and resize accordingly. Select both the clock and the home screen and center them horizontally. Select the Bezier tool or the pen tool and draw the mountain part that overlaps the clock. Now select both of them and go to Path Difference. Make the clock opaque and select the dropper tool by pressing D and select a suitable color from the image. Now duplicate the clock and give it a radial gradient. Give the center stopper a black color and adjust it to be at the top of the mountain to give a shadow effect. Now let's draw the buttons. Select the rectangle tool and draw and make the corners rounded. Snap it to the edge of the phone and give it a gradient of almost black. One side and pitch black to the other. Duplicate the button and adjust the length. Duplicate again. Now select the three buttons and group them by right-click Group. Send the group backwards. Now create a square by holding Ctrl-Shift. Send it backwards and give it a color of white. Select the circle tool and create an ellipse at the bottom of the phone and give it a black color. Send it to the back and one step forward. Adjust the blur to around 15 and resize. Duplicate the ellipse, adjust the size and increase the blur. Now decrease the opacity, send it to the back, and one step forward. Now duplicate the bottom edge of the phone and give the gradient a black color. Select all except the white background and group them. Now select all and duplicate. And give the white background of the second image to be black. Bring back the white glow at the bottom of the phone by adjusting the gradient color again. That's how you create the iPhone 14 Pro on Inkscape. Thank you for watching.